Good morning, everyone. How are you all? I feel you all are well. As I am going to tell you about bacteria, so yesterday I have told you about importance of fungi and bad effect of fungi, and today I am telling you about bacteria. Bacteria are living organism and can only be seen under a microscope. Bacteria are everywhere. Some bacteria are good and some are bad. I will explain this again. Bacteria are living organism. Living means as you are living, as bacteria also living, and can only be seen under a microscope. You can't see bacteria by your eyes. You can see under a microscope only. Bacteria are everywhere. Everywhere bacteria are present. No place on earth where bacteria are not. Everywhere. Some bacteria are good and some are bad. And bacteria are two type, good and bad. As bacteria in air, showing here, you can see. In air. Now you can see how many bacteria. Now bacteria on the surface of the tongue. On our tongue, bacteria are also present. And in food. Food when become rot, then bacteria present. And bacteria is not seeing by our eyes, as in a spoon bacteria are not seeing, but here in this picture it is by microscope and bacteria are showing here. So you understand what I am saying. Bacteria are everywhere. Bacteria are living things, and bacteria are good and bad both. And now you can see good bacteria, about good bacteria. So good bacteria are useful to us in many ways. Bacteria are useful in many ways, as bacteria in the roots of leguminous plants help to absorb nitrogen from the soil. You can understand what is this? Bacteria in the roots of leguminous plants. So the plants that are leguminous means pulses plants. Pulses means dal. As the plants leguminous, the bacteria live in the roots of the leguminous plants and absorb nitrogen from the soil. As you know that nitrogen is 78% in air, but after that, maybe 73, but after that we cannot breathe nitrogen. We can't take from air. Why? Because nitrogen we can't take from air. Some bacteria present that take nitrogen from the air, from soil, and convert into amino acids, nitric acids. So we can't take nitrogen from the air, and nitrogen is the minimum amount in air. So bacteria help to take nitrogen. And why nitrogen important, do you know? In our body, protein is very useful, and protein is made by nitrogen. And this nitrogen is very important because nitrogen take by the bacteria that is present in the leguminous plants. Next, you can see bacteria convert milk into curd. One name of bacteria is lactobacillus. You can see lactobacillus. Where written by lactobacillus? After bacteria. Convert milk into curd. So milk will convert into curd by lactobacillus bacteria. You like curd a lot, I know. You like lassi. So how lassi formed by milk? By lactobacillus bacteria. Your mother adds some curd in milk. So this curd having bacteria, good bacteria, and they reproduce and they convert full milk into curd. So which bacteria present in curd? Tell the name, lactobacillus. Now next one. Bacteria live in our intestine and help in digestion. You know, bacteria is also present in our intestine. We are having two intestine, you know, small intestine or large intestine. Yes, you know, in last year you have read this. So bacteria live in our intestine and help in digestion. So digestion will good, then you will be happy, healthy. Now listen, these are the useful effect of bacteria. First one is bacteria help to convert nitrogen present in the soil into amino acids. and plants take this nitrogen, plants convert this in protein. So bacteria in the roots of leguminous plants help to absorb nitrogen from the soil. Bacteria also help to turn milk into cheese, butter and yogurt. Do you know what is yogurt? Yogurt is also a curd made by soya. Bacteria cause many diseases in humans, plants and animals. Do you know bacteria grow on our teeth and cause teeth decay? Your teeth sometimes smell from your mouth. Coming smell or not? Sometime. So no jigyasa, they actually grow on food particles that get stuck between our teeth. I will explain all these things. Bacteria are also the cause of some other disease. Now listen. Whenever you take food and you did not brush, what happened, do you know? In morning, your mouth starts smelling. Why? Because bacteria grow in your mouth. And from where bacteria come? As you eat food and somewhere food is stuck in our mouth, and this food rot. सड़ जाता है फूड और इस फूड में बैक्टीरिया ग्रो हो जाते हैं और यही बैक्टीरिया हमारे टूथ डेकाय करते हैं. डेकाय में सड़ जाते हैं. सो ये जो बैक्टीरिया है एसिड प्रोड्यूस करते हैं. एसिड क्या है? हमारे दांतों को सड़ा देता है. दे स्टार्ट कैविटी. सो बैक्टीरिया प्रोड्यूस एसिड इन आर टीथ एंड कॉज कैविटी इन आर टीथ. सो बैक्टीरिया आर बैड that grow in our mouth, in food, that start cavity in our mouth. Now, some bacteria can grow in absence of oxygen on air. Some bacteria can grow in absence of oxygen or air and they are called anaerobic bacteria. You can understand this. Some bacteria don't need oxygen. In absence of air, they grow. You need oxygen? Yes, some bacteria don't need. So they are called anaerobic bacteria. And some bacteria grow in the presence of air. They are called aerobic bacteria. I will tell you tomorrow more about bacteria class. So thank you everyone. Bye.